Hi everybody, this is Lars Vemje, and welcome to the first episode of .Nuke. In this video series, I will be reviewing commercial tools for Foundry's Nuke. These videos will not be like the useful Nukepedia tools videos. They will be about what the commercial tools can generally do, why they are awesome, how much they cost, and where you can buy them. The first episode of .Nuke will be about V-Ray for Nuke, which I love very much because I love Foundry's Nuke and I'm also deeply in love with V-Ray from Chaosgroup. And with V-Ray for Nuke, we have the best of both worlds. More and more people are adapting the V-Ray for Nuke workflow, like Ari Rubenstein, who is using it to render his animated short movie called The Blue Scrap. You can check out a teaser of his short film on his Vimeo page. Before I continue, I want to thank my friend Shaheen Tusi, who is a very talented digital artist from London, who helped me out with these V-Ray for Nuke examples. V-Ray is an Academy Award-winning ray traced renderer that has become an industry standard just like Arnold or RenderMan. It gives you a lot of granular control and provides you with loads of tools that help you to achieve your rendering goals. V-Ray for Nuke is awesome and one of a kind because it is a production-proven 3D render engine inside of Nuke that is second to none when it comes to 3D render output and render quality within Nuke. It breaks the regular way of a VFX pipeline, which in this case is a very good thing, because it combines look development, lighting, and compositing into one user experience. This way of working is certainly not for everybody, but it can enable a certain type of artist to be very flexible and efficient while maintaining a high-end quality output that is paramount for the world of visual effects. Here are some of the features of V-Ray for Nuke. Deep rendering, live render element output for refinement and compositing, which recently also includes CryptoMat, OpenVDB, global illumination, production-ready textures, VR cameras, instancing of V-Ray proxy objects using Nuke's particle system, V-Ray scene file rendering, which is a closed 3D scene container that includes features like animated geometry, shading, lighting and texture information, and much more. Now you can get V-Ray for Nuke at chaosgroup.com/V-Ray/Nuke, and it starts at 750 euros for one permanent workstation license. Is it worth the money? A definite yes, and every single penny of it is my personal opinion. But to make it even easier for everybody to start using this tool, you can also rent V-Ray for Nuke for a monthly fee of 60 euros or an annual fee of 380 euros. Before I leave, I wanted to mention that Nukepedia's NuBridge is now compatible with Nuke 11. The NuBridge is the direct link between Nuke and Nukepedia, which makes for a very pleasant user experience while looking for your next useful Nukepedia tool that can potentially save you a lot of time or help you in your day-to-day work with Foundry's Nuke. Alright, that's it for the first episode of .Nuke. I hope you liked it. Again, my name is Lars Vemje. Thanks for watching. And goodbye, everybody.